Good morning, everyone. I hope you're having as enjoyable a Christmas as it's possible to have in the present circumstances. Recording a Christmas message makes me feel like the Queen. But unlike the Queen, who produces a Christmas message every year, I pray that this is the only year I ever have to record a Christmas message. Opting not to have a Christmas morning service was a difficult decision to take because it's always a very special service. But this decision was taken so that there'd be 72 hours between services in our meeting house. You can be sure that we're seeking to do everything that's required of us to keep our church family safe during the current pandemic. So please join with us when we meet together on Sunday for our Christmas service. Boys and girls, please remember to send me a photo of one of your gifts today or tomorrow, and I'll let everyone see it on the screens on Sunday. Also bring your gift along with you on Sunday. Each day during this Advent season, I've been posting a devotional about hope on the church Facebook page. Today I want to think about how we can have hope in a world that's blighted by COVID-19. So I'm going to read John chapter 1, verses 1 to 14. This is God's word we're reading. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was with God in the beginning. Through him all things were made. Without him nothing was made that has been made. In him was life, and that life was the light of man. The light shines in the darkness, but the darkness has not understood it. There came a man who was sent from God. His name was John. He came as a witness to testify concerning that light, so that through him all men might believe. He himself was not the light. He came only as a witness to the light. The true light that gives light to every man was coming into the world. He was in the world, and though the world was made through him, the world did not recognize him. He came to that which was his own, but his own did not receive him. Yet to all who received him, to those who believed in his name, he gave the right to become the children of God. Children born not of natural descent, nor of human decision, or of a husband's will, but born of God. The Word became flesh and made his dwelling among us. We have seen his glory, the glory of the one and only, who came from the Father, full of grace and truth. Amen. We thank God for his Word. And we pray that he will bless it to our understanding. . 2020 is unlikely to go down as anyone's favorite year, unless they're a major shareholder in Amazon or Zoom. Throughout this year, life has been harder, less certain, and more fearful as a result of the coronavirus. In difficult times, we look for something to hold on to. We seek for something to look forward to. We want someone to assure us it will get better. But at the moment, it's hard to see things getting better anytime soon. However, we can still have real hope. To find this hope, we need to look to the first Christmas. When Jesus was born, about 2,000 years ago in Palestine, things weren't easy either. Jesus was born into a people who were suffering oppression and injustice, and into a family who became refugees. Since Jesus was born in dark times, it's not surprising that John said about the first Christmas, "The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness has not overcome it." The first Christmas was all about light coming into the darkness and triumphing over it. Jesus coming into the world was all about hope driving out fear. As John continues the introduction to his gospel, he gives us three descriptions of Jesus that show us how he brought hope. John says, "The Word became flesh and dwelt among us, and we have seen his glory, glory as of the only Son from the Father, full of grace and truth." First of all, John tells us in that verse, which I have just read, that Jesus came from the Father? Is this world a place that's essentially chaotic, or is it under control? This year has shown us that mankind certainly can't control what goes on in the world. So if there's no one behind what we can see, then chaos is all we can expect in the world. But if there's a divine being who made everything, then there's someone who's bigger than this life, and they're able to control this world. The first Christmas lets us know that there is such a God. It tells us that the God at the heart of the universe is a God of relationship, because he is Father, Son, and Spirit. The fact that the only Son came from a throne in heaven to a manger on earth means that he has experienced tiredness, hunger, thirst, betrayal, and pain. Christmas shows us that God is in control of this world, so it's not in chaos. But what's God doing? The second thing that John tells us about Jesus is that he's full of grace. Our conversation is now full of phrases we never uttered before 2020, such as social distancing, self-isolate, track and trace, the R number, and so on. But we need to be sure that our 2021 is shaped by a different phrase. And that phrase is overwhelming, unconditional kindness. This is what the word grace means. And Jesus shows us that God is full of grace. Because he's full of kindness, Jesus is preparing to remake this world into one without sickness, pain, death, or grief. There'll be no more uncertainty or fear in this new world. Instead, there'll be joy and peace. This is the life we're all looking for, and yet we feel very far from it right now. This is what God is directing the world towards. Even when from our very limited human perspective, the route seems very strange. Because he's full of kindness, Jesus was born to do everything that's necessary for us to be able to enter into this renewed world, no matter who we are or what we've done. By dying and rising back to life, Jesus has provided a way through death and out the other side into eternal life. Because he's full of kindness, Jesus offers the forgiveness we all need for our sin. Sin describes all the ways that we have lived as if we're in charge of the world, rather than God being in charge of it. Jesus offers us forgiveness, and this is an unconditional offer, in the sense that we don't have to earn it or deserve it, which is a good job, because we couldn't earn it and we don't deserve it. All we need to do is humbly accept this forgiveness as a gift. Things may not get better in 2021. In our lifetime, things may never get back to how they were before this pandemic. But Christmas lets us know that one day things will be better than they have ever been before. And we're invited to enjoy that future forever by the God who desires to shower us with overwhelming, unconditional kindness, with grace. The third thing that John tells us about Jesus is that he's full of truth. It's hard to find your way in the dark. When we walk our dog Holly on the Tullyhannan Road in these winter nights, we need a torch. 2020 has felt as if the journey of our lives has turned off a well-lit motorway onto some dark, unfamiliar country lanes which aren't programmed into our sat-nav. We have been confronted by this scary reality that we have only one life, and we're often unclear about how best to live it or what are the right decisions to make about it. Jesus is full of truth because he's the God who understands the paths, who directs the future, and who knows us better than we know ourselves. Jesus' truth is sometimes unsettling because it's not always in line with our views. But his truth is always liberating because he offers us the insight and the guidance we need. Jesus knows the way we need to take and the decisions we need to make. This Christmas, more than any Christmas in our lifetime, we're in need of hope. John claims that Christmas brings hope because the person who's in control of this world is the only Son who came from the Father, and he's full of grace and truth. Jesus is the light that will overcome even the deepest darkness. And Jesus offers to guide us through this life and give us a perfect future beyond this life. The question is, do you have this hope? Because you're trusting in everything Jesus came to accomplish for you through his life, death, and resurrection. What I've said today is based on a little tract entitled Christmas Hope in a COVID World. If you would like one of those for yourself or to give to someone, please contact me and I will get it to you. Let us pray and let us ask God to apply these lessons we have learned from his word to our heart. Let us pray. Our loving Heavenly Father, we praise you that your only Son, Jesus, came from you into this world to be the light that would overcome the darkness of sin, death, and hell. We bless you that Jesus is full of grace and truth. Thank you for all that he accomplished on behalf of his people through his perfect life of obedience to your will, his atoning death on the cross, and his victorious resurrection from the grave. We praise you for the sure and certain hope that you give us when we trust Jesus to be our Lord and Saviour. We bless you that this hope means that we can face whatever lies ahead with confidence, because we know that you're in control of this world, you're in control of our life, and you're in control of our eternity. In Jesus' gracious name we pray. Amen. We're going to finish today with the hymn, You're the Word of God the Father. This hymn is based on the words that we read from John chapter 1 and we thought about it.